Joyeux Noël! Feliz Navidad! Merry Christmas!
It is such a pleasure to join with you this evening to celebrate Christmas, the birth of our Savior, Jesus the Christ. Throughout human history, peoples have gathered on momentous occasions, as families, as communities, as a planet. We have gathered to share the stories of our ancestors, the mysteries of our faith, to share our own stories, to see the stories of others, the stories of sports events or breaking news around the world. We have gathered around campfires. We have gathered at the kitchen table. We have gathered in churches and in temples. We have gathered in arenas. This night, we gather as households. The flickering flames of campfires, lanterns, and candles has evolved into the flickering of screens. To protect the vulnerable, to support our healthcare heroes, to flatten the curve, we cannot gather in a physical way, but in a virtual way, which is still a real and profound way to connect. We give thanks for the technology and resources that allow us to do this. We think of those who are working this holy night to keep the power on and the internet streaming, those who keep us safe and comfortable, warm and fed. Tonight, we will retell the story of Jesus' birth, a story full of meaning and mystery, of answers and questions, of darkness and light. Part of the mystery of Jesus' story is that his story is our story. Our story is his story. As a human family, as communities, as individuals. Tonight we will hear from those who were there at the first Christmas, but from whom we've probably never heard before. The lamp, the manger, the staff, and a gift. These objects come alive and are full of meaning for us when we activate them. They become an extension of ourselves. What is a gift unless it is given and received? What is a lantern unless someone lights it and it provides guidance? Similarly, the life of God, born in a baby in Bethlehem many, many years ago, becomes activated within us even today, this very evening, when we open our hearts to hope, peace, joy, and love. Jesus invites us to empower his life to flourish in our world today by being a people of love and service, by making our world a place of life and abundance for all. Thank you all for so generously contributing your part to this story, in sharing your videos, in being part of communities, in just being you. Let's keep the story alive through our own lives of Christian discipleship. So where should we start? At the beginning, of course.
The Gospel according to John, chapter 1, verses 1 to 5. In the beginning, when all things began, the Word already was. The Word dwelt with God, and what God was, the Word was. The Word made flesh in Christ was with God at the beginning, and through him all things came to be. No single thing was created without him. All that came to be was alive with his life, and that life was the light of mankind. The light shines on in the dark, and the darkness has never overcome it.
Lighting of Christ Candle and Advent Wreath Candles. O come all ye faithful, and come all ye doubtful. We are here to feel the warmth of hope. As we light the candle of hope, we remember the light that shines this night is a light that nothing can overcome. We pray at this time for all who are discouraged, who are facing illness, either in themselves or of loved ones. We pray in hope. O come all ye peaceful, and come all ye stressed out. We are here to feel the glow of peace. As we light the candle of peace, we take a deep breath in and out and remember the meaning of Christmas. We breathe out and let go of all the busyness of shopping, cleaning, cooking, and baking. We breathe in the peace of the Christ child, that new baby smell. O come all ye joyous and come all ye grieving. We are here to feel a blaze or even just a flicker of joy. As we light the candle of joy, we remember all the blessings of this time, the memories and traditions we treasure and recreate each year, the feasting, the sharing, and the laughter. We also pray for all those who struggle with sadness during this season. We pray for all who have lost ones, loved ones, and are grieving. We pray for fractured family relationships and friendships that are often mourned at this time of year. We pray for wholeness and joy for all of God's people. O come all ye righteous, and come all ye who have messed up. We come to encounter the love that is the light of the world. As we light the candle of love, we offer this love to ourselves and to each other. Through the grace of God, let us lean into forgiveness, recognizing that we are all imperfect, but that God loves us just as we are. Let us also commit to sharing this love with friends, family, strangers, and even those we consider enemies. O come all ye contented, and come all ye searching for more. We are here to open ourselves to the presence of God. As we light the Christ candle, we offer our hearts, minds, and spirits to the holy mystery that is the heart of Christmas. A lowly birth, a child who is the Son of God, a foreshadowing of everlasting life, and a message of God's love for humanity. Let us pray. Loving God, you who are holy mystery, we come to you today in this season of long nights, seeking the bright flame of your hope for our own healing and for the healing of the world. As we look toward the candles of hope, peace, joy, and love, the candles that surround the Christ candle, we silently pray to you, surrendering our hopes and fears and allowing your light to shine into us. Loving God, help us to surrender our burdens and celebrate with joy. Amen.
The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness will not overcome it. A lamp shines into the darkness, a pinpoint of light in a dark night. We know how our eyes will find even the tiniest spark of light when everything around us is dark. For light is stronger than the darkness. At night, when a lamp is burning, open the door on the darkness and see what happens. The lamplight shines out and takes over a bit of the darkness. Never does a piece of darkness fall into a lighted room and take away some of the light. Even a simple lamp enjoys the power of light. Its flame allows the light to shine where we need it, into the darkest corners of house or stable. A single lamp can show us the pathway on the darkest night, so no one stumbles while carrying a precious gift. A lamp shining in the doorway welcomes us in from our wandering. Its warmth pushes away our worries, just like its light pushes away the dark.
A reading from Luke 2, verses 1 through 5. In those days a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child.
Without hands to strike the match and light the wick. A lamp cannot light itself. What is a lamp without hands to hold it up so its light shines into those dark corners? A lamp cannot lift itself high. What is a lamp without hands to open the door and let the lamp light shine out into the darkness? A lamp cannot open the door. A lamp needs a life to look into the darkness and see who needs light to brighten their path. A lamp needs a life to light the wick and set the light shining. A lamp needs a life to open the door and hold it up high. A life that will welcome a stranger into the light, into the warmth, into the heart, into a hearth.
Let us pray. O God, shine your light into our lives on this dark night. Warm our hearts so that we will open our doors to your love. May ours be the lives that shine light into the dark corners of your world. May ours be the lives that welcome you to be born again in our midst this Christmas. Amen.
What is a manger? Just a few pieces of wood nailed together to serve a good purpose. That's all a manger is. Just a set of wooden arms strong enough to hold a new bundle of hay each day. Still, a manger protects its bed of hay, keeps it clean and dry, keeps the mice away. A manger stands guard to offer its food, its source of life, to animals who rely on its steady footing. That manger always stands ready for whoever needs its nourishing cargo. That manger will open its wooden arms to welcome the hungry lives which gather around it, lives that trust the manger holds what they need for the future.
Luke chapter 2, verse 6 and 7. While they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child.
And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because
there was no place for them in the inn.
But how can a manger become a cradle for more than a bundle of hay? How can a cradle without arms to prepare the bed and welcome more precious cargo? Can a manger become a cradle without hands to lay a newborn to rest? Hands which settle and soothe and tend new life? Can a manger be a cradle without hands, tiny and perfect, reaching up, reaching out for the attention, for warmth, for love? A cradle needs a life to smooth the bed and smooth the forehead. A cradle needs a life to rock the baby and sing the soothing lullaby. A cradle needs a life to shelter, resting its tiny head, trusting itself to the manger's wooden arms and the mother's willing arms.
Let us pray. O God, may our lives cradle your love this Christmas as we smile on the baby Jesus. May our love become a shelter for those who turn to us for protection. May our arms offer the welcome every stranger needs. In the name of Jesus, who reaches out to us from the manger. Amen.
The staff speaks. Not much goes into a staff. It's cut from a tree and carved to be useful out there in the wild. A staff is just a walking stick, sturdy and dependable. Something to lean on if you're weary. A staff gives the extra footing when the path is slippery, or your knee is stiff or sore, feeling the weather on a cold, damp night. For a shepherd, a staff offers a bit of support along a rocky path. That staff gives an occasional prod to remind a stubborn sheep to move along to the next green pasture. And a staff with a bit of a curve comes in handy when a wayward lamb gets stuck in a crevice or in a muddy patch in the field.
The reading is from Luke 2, verses 8 to 16. In that region, there were shepherds living in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. Then an angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I am bringing you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Messiah, the Lord. This will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger." And suddenly, there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heavens, and on earth peace among them whom God favors." When the angels had left them and gone into heaven, the shepherds said to each other, "Let us go now to Bethlehem and see this thing that has taken place, which the Lord has made known to us." So they went with haste and found Mary and Joseph and a child lying in the manger.
Thank you.
But what is a staff without hands to grip it firmly? What is a staff without hands to place it wisely for sure support? What is a staff without hands to prod that sheep gently through the winding valley? Hands to hook the crook around the silly lamb that got stuck and pull it to safety. A staff needs a life to test its strength. A staff needs a life to lean on its dependability. A staff needs a life who knows the sheep and sees how they go astray. A staff needs a life unafraid of the danger. A life to kneel down and rescue the lamb, pulling it free, guiding it on the way.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus Christ, we have come to find you this Christmas. Be our staff to lean on when we lose our footing. Be our guide when we cannot find our way. Pull us free from danger. Savior, rescue us with the light of your love. Be our strength now and in the year ahead, so that we may walk with your courage and compassion, come what may. Amen.
A gift speaks. Christmas is a time of gift giving. Think of all the gifts wrapped up and waiting under your tree. Each gift is a piece of love, chosen for someone special. Each gift is a piece of hope, waiting to change someone's life. Each gift is that little piece of joy, given to make someone smile.
Scripture reading, Matthew 2, 1 and 2, 9 to 11. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we have observed his star at its rising and have come to pay him homage."
When they had heard the king, they set out, and there ahead of them went the star that they had seen at its rising, until it stopped over a place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother, and they knelt down and paid him homage. Then, opening their treasure chest, they offered him gifts of gold, frankincense, and myrrh.
What child is this who lay to rest on Mary's lap is sleeping, whom angels greet with anthems sweet, while shepherds watch are keeping? This is Christ the King, shepherds guard and angels sing. Haste, haste to bring him, Lord, the babe, the Son of Mary. Then bring him incense, gold and myrrh. Come, peasant king, to own him, the king.
Yet what is a gift without hands to present it? What is a gift without hands to unwrap it? And what is a gift without hands to hold it up in wonder, to cherish it, to play with it, to touch the love it bears and make that love your own. A gift needs a life to give it. A gift needs a life to receive it. A gift needs a life to unwrap the love inside and share that love outside with all who wonder how love can give so much. The Christ child is a life born for us, born with us, to offer us God's gift. The Christ child is a gift with love for each of us, so wonderful that we can share that love with others and never have that love run out. Christ is the gift God gives us tonight. Christ is the gift we receive tonight. Unwrap this gift for yourself and share this gift of love with everyone whose life touches yours.
Of the people. God of the starry heavens and good green earth, eternal God, Emmanuel, God with us, you have come among us in the figure of a baby, a newborn reaching out to us to bring a smile to our lips and hope to our hearts. Thank you for your tenderness with which you touch our lives. This Christmas, as we remember the baby lying in a manger, we pray for peace. Peace in all the places where there is anger or war or fear. Peace in all the hearts that know sorrow or stress. We pray for people who will not sleep safely tonight because of conflict in their lives. Cradle all these people and places in your love, so the world may sleep in heavenly peace this night. This Christmas, as we remember the Mother Mary rocking her baby, we pray for all children born this Christmas season. Watch over mothers and fathers and grandparents, hoping for the best for their newborns. Help us create communities where every child is valued and every family has enough. May families rejoice because Christ the Savior is born for us, for each of us and for all of us. This Christmas, as we remember the Father Joseph protecting his little one, we pray for all those watching over the helpless and hopeless this season. be with all those who must work this holiday, to keep the world safe, to care for the sick and those in need, to keep us safe. Be with those who are sick or sad or lonely, so that each one will know your tender touch. God of the starry heavens and good green earth, eternal God, Emmanuel, God with us, this Christmas, as we remember the shepherds coming in haste and the magi coming in wonder, open our hearts to reach out to the Christ child, to receive the gift you offer us in Jesus, even as we offer our love to you in his name. Bless us in the year ahead so that we can share your love with all the lives that touch ours. May our hearts sing with the Christmas angels. And gathering our prayers and praises into one, we pray in the words that Jesus taught us, the Lord's Prayer.
Notre Père qui es aux cieux, que ton nom soit sanctifié.
Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Oh. us, Lord, at thy birth. Jesus, Lord, at thy birth.
To you is born this day the Savior, Jesus, Christ the Lord. May the love of Jesus embrace you, the joy of Jesus fill your heart, the peace of Jesus give you rest, and the hope of Jesus guide you in the year ahead. May Almighty God bless you and keep you. Amen. Go in peace. Thanks be to God.
We wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas, we wish you a Merry Christmas and a Happy New Year.
Merry Christmas, everybody. Happy New Year. Hope 2021 is better than 2020.
Hi, this is Deborah Parker from Kelowna, British Columbia, wishing everyone in the Meridian Pastoral Charge a happy and healthy Merry Christmas. Bye.
Hey, Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas. All the best in the new year.
Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to everyone from the Ale House. Have a safe and happy season.
Merry Christmas all from the Harrisons and LaSalle. Have a great new year.
Merry Christmas from the Harrisons.
Enjoy your Noël.
Play the lake, y'all.
Merry Christmas, everyone.
Merry Christmas, everyone at Meridian Pastoral Charge. And Mom and I would like to wish you a Merry Christmas and a Healthy New Year.
We wish you a Merry Christmas and a peaceful holiday season with all of your families.
Merry Christmas!
Merry Christmas, everyone!
I want to wish you a Merry Christmas.